Honey, allow me to be your sign that you have been asking for and been needing to let go of that situation that has been doing nothing but causing you stress and anxiety, honey. It is not worth it for it to be living in your mind rent-free and you're not being paid for it, honey. Hey, girl. Hello, my beautiful Virgo. How are you doing? My name is Simply Velka, and today I'm going to be doing your weekly tarot reading today. So if you find any tarot cards that resonate with you in this weekly reading for you, Virgo, let me know in the comments below which tarot cards do and how they do, because that is how I keep up with you guys, is through the comments as well. Virgo, I would appreciate it if you enjoy this reading or you just enjoy my vibe. I would really appreciate it if you were to give this video a like and subscribe, because it does help out my tarot reading channel a lot, and I always am super appreciative of it when you guys take the extra step to do that for me. And finally, before we get into this reading today, Virgo, I just want to remind you to use your intuition, because put it in perspective, I'm just a man reading some tarot cards to you. You know your situation better than I ever possibly could, so take the tarot cards that resonate and leave what doesn't. I believe my tarot cards, my tarot readings are just here to give you some food for thought, a perspective for you to consider as you go throughout your week, but never making the decision in your life, right? So, all that being said now, finally, let's get into your weekly reading. I pulled some tarot cards for you just so I could get an idea of where it is that my Virgo is at right now. And so right now we have I have a sneeze coming up, so if you see me making funny faces, Virgo, it's me trying to like figure this mess out internally. All right, so we have the Unity card, Archangel Sandalphon. So if you are open to working with archangels, Virgo, depending on your belief system, I guess, of course, Archangel Sandalphon would be a lovely archangel for you to be. How many times can I say archangel in 10 seconds? Sandalphon would be a lovely archangel to work with this week. Also, the number 5, write down the number 5, Virgo, for numerology to see what messages the number has, and see how it correlates with this reading and for your week. We also have the 5 of Water, continuing on with the 5, or the 5 of Cups, because Cups is water energy. The 5 of... Honey, yes, definitely Virgo. If you didn't write it down before, pause this video or just let me babble on and like make a separate tab right now as I'm speaking, Virgo, and look up number 5, like angel number 5, numerology, or like meaning, not angel number, don't do angel number, look up I almost said angel number again, number 5, numerology meaning of number 5, but 5 of Wands or 5 of Fire, right? Because fire is equal to, Wands is fire energy. My gosh, I cannot, I'm sorry Virgo, y'all are the last earth signs that I'm doing, so I'm a little bit loopy at this point, full transparency. And then Virgo, you have the 6 of Earth, or the 6 of Pentacles, because Pentacle is Earth energy. So, give me a moment, Virgo, as I figure out how this puzzle wants to be figured out right now. Because I think we're going to do this one here, honey. We're going to do this one here. We're going to do this one here. And we're going to do this one here. That feels the most right. What do you think, Virgo? I'm asking y'all, and you don't even see the cards. Let's start with this, Virgo. the 5 of Fire, 5 of Wands. This card says computing goals or bothersome details in conflict with other people. So we're going to hone in this card, the message of conflict. Virgo, there's some type of conflict or obstacle that we'll say on your path right now that you've been dealing with, Virgo. So let's get a little bit more detail on this, right? What it is, what has been slowing you down or like distracting you, because I do feel like it was a distraction of sorts. Six cards. I wish, honey. I don't wish there was 6 cards, but 4 cards came out for you. Such a mess, Virgo. I apologize. I did your bonus reading, by the way, which I promise you wasn't nearly as messy, I don't think, and I'll leave a link to that if you want to check that out instead. Please watch both. No, the Sun card, the clarifiers for your 5 of Fire, Sun card, with the 9 of Cups. the Death card with the King of Pentacles. So, honey, Virgo said, like, honey, we have this conflict, darling. That's fine. Like, we'll cut this out right real quick. Virgo has no patience whatsoever right now when it comes to their path. Anything that's an obstacle or anything that's distracting them of their energy, Virgo is just like, we're going to cancel this out right now. You know, it doesn't matter what that is. We're going to multiply that by zero, honey, to equal it to zero. It doesn't matter what number that is. It doesn't matter what level of BS that they're bringing. You're canceling it out and you're just choosing to cut it out, right? So, this brings forth a lot of comfort for me. It's not that serious, Falco, but I guess it is for me, honey. But it brings comfort for me because it shows that, because normally when I see this conflict card, the Five of Wands, I'm just kind of like, ugh, I wonder how my zodiac sign is doing, because it's like, you know, this can really distract you. You know, it's one of those times where it's like, Michelle Obama says, it's one of her quotes where it's just like, when they go low, we go high, or something like that, right? It's one of those things of just like not letting this distract you, right? Whether it's conflict with the person or whether it's just like a bump in the road, like a health scare, or just, you know, some things just not working out. It can really distract you. But for you, Virgo, when I see this death energy, you're just cutting things out. Or I guess that is me being optimistic, Virgo, because we could consider this like, the conflict being like the ending of some type of like an abrupt ending to a situation. But I don't really feel like it's like that case for most of you Virgos, because we have these beautiful cards after the fact. We have with the King of Pentacles. This is the card of just extreme stability. This is what it is that you are, only thing that you're allowing in your life is stability and things that will continue to elevate you and make you feel good and make you feel safe and secure with yourself and just with where it is that the energy that you keep yourself around, right? The Nine of Cups comes in of just like that self-fulfillment. Like, again, like you're very much so the choices and like views that you have in your life right now, Virgo, is very based off of like what is feeling good to you, right? And I guess it would make sense as to why you would just be such a dismissive energy to the conflict, right? The Sun card is what it is that you're chasing, right? And it's just, again, like all about just like that happiness. This is very much so an energy, Virgo, where it's just like, unless you're coming at me with some good vibes, darling, don't come at me at all, right? Because this is all you're searching for, is those good high vibrational vibes, which, honey, I love for you, Virgo. So I celebrate you for that. Because I know in your bonus reading, you guys, I think, had a pretty heavy reading. Heavy in a good way, but I know you guys are like really mentally going through it. So I'm really glad that you guys are not only coming out of that, but not internalizing whatever happened to you guys previously. You guys are just keeping it going. Because you have the Five of Water here. I do see you guys coming out of it still. Some of you guys, you may be dealing with like the remnants, but that's fine. Virgo, don't feel bad about it. Don't be hard on yourself if you're still like having a little bit of unsettled emotions or feelings on it, because it's just natural, right? You're only human. I feel like a lot of people, it's just like, oh, you don't want to like be in this low vibrational state where it's just like feeling resentful or whatever. And it's like, yeah, you don't want to feel that way, but sometimes it's inevitable, Virgo, right? This card says things not turning out the way that you'd hope, not seeing the positive in a situation, and crying over spilled milk. So this is, again, I feel like the energy you're getting out of, though. So let's get some clarifying cards, though, to see if we can get any more detail on this. I feel like we're gonna use this one. We're gonna use this one. We're gonna not use this one. Didn't use this one. Okay. All right, let me get these cards set up. All right, so the clarifying cards, Virgo, that we have for your Five of Water, your Five of Cups, you have the Empress card with the Seven of Swords, the Queen of Swords. Oh, Virgo. See, this is what I was talking about, honey. Like, whatever that situation was, like, while you no longer, in like, I say no longer, you aren't interested, I'll say, Virgo, in like those low vibrational vibes, right? We'll just summarize all that and put it in one big conglomerate of just like low vibe, right? Insert your negative adjective here. It really puts you on guard. It's like one of those things where it's like, for you, Virgo, you're in this state of where it's just like, you know what? I'm not gonna entertain this, not going to sink and like let this distract me for too long, but at the same time trust and believe that I'm going to learn from it and put up the proper it's like you're almost getting more protective each time something tries you. And so I know you're kind of like, okay, well, how does it sound bad, Velka? Why'd you make that dramatic face and all those noises from before? Like, if you're, you know, it sounds like you're setting up just like good boundaries, right? But I'm getting the sense here, right, as you continue with those life experiences that you're dealing with, as you, like, the universe and just, you know, people or just like in situations keep trying you with that Five of Wands, because I feel like it's like a constant barrage of things for you, Virgo. I don't feel like it's necessarily one specific thing that's like the be all for it. You start having a little bit more of a cynical nature or a cynical view on things, right? You start being a lot less trusting, right? With the Seven of Swords, right? Because it's like you get hurt and you just really, at this point, then it's like an energy where it's just like, all right, like this person here hurt you. So that means anyone that tries to come close to you any time after this, like anyone that tries to pursue you, you're just going to think wants to hurt you or is out to get you, right? Just a very distrustful energy. And the Queen of Swords paired with it is just like amplifying this. It's almost like the sense of where you're like becoming more and more introverted and really just closing yourself off from like anything ever getting close to you again, which is just like I just want to say, be careful about it, Virgo, right? You know what you're doing, best, and I just need to mind my business, right? It's none of my business how you handle things, and you're right, but I mean, I'm seeing it in these cards, honey. So maybe listen to me if you want to hear these cards, but just be careful about not letting these situations make you cynical, right? Remember that don't internalize things, even if it does feel personal. Remember that it's not, and just keep it going, right? You don't want to punish yourself because you were, just because something screwed you over, Virgo. You don't want to punish yourself by blocking yourself off and making it harder for things and blessings to come in the future just because of that other situation that screwed you over. Doesn't mean anything else in the future that comes is going to keep with that energy, because I don't think it's going to. But yeah, so now let's get into your Six of Earth or your Six of Pentacles energy. We have, this card says, gifts of money, time, and effort, new career opportunities, receiving a loan or paying off a debt. Now, this is the card I like to more so focus on things coming into balance, right? So I do, again, see you overcoming that Five of Cups situation and having things come into balance for you. But, of course, let's see if we can get any more information on this, Capricorn. Mm-hmm. Use this card. We're gonna do this one. We're gonna do this one. All right. So the clarifiers that we have going on for you, we have the Eight of Pentacles, the Four of Pentacles with the Star card. So, what I would say, Capricorn, is just like whatever that situation was before, right? Even if something didn't screw you over, but for simplicity's sake of getting the message across, let's just say like someone screwed you over, someone betrayed you. Allow that to be like a learning lesson of figuring out where it is that you want to invest your pentacles into, or how like the standard of person that you want to accept in your life, right? Don't be closed off to any new person in the future, because that's just unrealistic, Capricorn, right? Like, clearly there's more good people than bad, and like clearly like not everyone is bad, right? don't block yourself out. Allow it to just be to teach you something, right? I know it's such a corny thing to say, Capricorn, where it's just like, just let the bad situations teach you, like ask what it is, think about what it's there to teach you, whatever. But truly, just allow it to put up proper boundaries of being like, okay, I don't like this behavior, I don't like that behavior, what have you. But leave it at those behaviors. Don't just be like, all right, all humans are bad, right? Like, and I know it's like such an easy cop-out to say, it's just like, oh, I don't like people. And it's just like, no, like, you can say you don't like people, and I'm guilty of it too. I've gone a whole week without talking to a single soul before, online and in person. But we're social beings, right? Deep down, we still want to be understood by other people, right? The Star card. I know there's this sense of you craving Capricorn, just being around an environment that's conducive to your growth, being surrounded by things and people that really just can understand you, right? And this is where the Unity card, Archangel Sandalphon, comes in for you, Capricorn, because Archangel Sandalphon is the individual who brings people together in their paths. I at least see it as that way. This card says traditional viewpoints or methods, spiritual organization, seeking out mentors and like-minded friends. And so, yeah, as I was saying, like, I view Archangel Sandalphon, he's always just the individual that I see, like, very subtly will, like, connect two people's paths together that are needing to be, link up in some way. It may not be immediately, right? Maybe further out in the distance that he connects those two paths together, that you guys walk together, but it's inevitable. And, you know, you can kind of guarantee whenever Archangel Sandalphon shows up in your life in that way, it's kind of letting you know, it's like, hey, somewhere in the future, like, your path's connecting up with some people. So keep that in mind. So it makes sense as to why I was saying before, and the message I was trying to relay to you before, Virgo, where it's just like, just because this one person was a jerk to you doesn't mean all people are jerks, right? Let's get some clarification on this, though. Let's see what's going on here. Overall, though, aside from me not being able to speak properly for y'all's reading so far, Virgo, it seems to be an extremely good reading for y'all. And the clarifying cards continue on with this message. The clarifiers that we have for your Unity card, Virgo, is the Ace of Cups with the Three of Pentacles and the Ten of Pentacles. So whoever is coming into your path, Virgo, because I do definitely see someone coming into your path. It doesn't have to be romantic at all, right? Very potentially could for their appropriate Capricorn, right? If you're single, right? Because you have the Ace of Cups, which if you go to any other tarot reader and you see the Ace of Cups, it's like a new love. Like, that's the moment you would see, like, most tarot readers, myself included. I don't think I actually have done that, but yet. when you'll, like, title is like, oh, new love coming or something, when you see, like, the Ace of Cups. But it doesn't have to be, because you also have this Three of Pentacles here. So it could just be a collaborative thing and makes you more open, like, you, so you're just like more open to working with other people, being a team player, right? Because it brings forth a lot of stability for you. So I was jumping around, but I didn't really get into the cards themselves. Three of Pentacles is the collaborative energy, contracts, right? This is a card of contracts, documents, working together overall on an equal goal. Ace of Cups is this, again, kind of like emphasis on just opening your heart up, being open to opportunities and possibilities, being open, again, to collaborative energies, whether it's in an intimate way that you're collaborating with or in a professional way with the Three of Pentacles, right? This person plays, like, wherever Archangel Sandalphon is bringing you with, whether it's one person or a group of people, because keep in mind, like, it is spoken, like, seek out mentors and like-minded friends. It did speak in plurals. Ten of Pentacles comes in. This is that happy family life, the stability, having your cake and eating it too, right? Feeling extremely, you're not lacking, essentially, Capricorn, in any sense of the word. So, very good reading for you, Capricorn. Just make sure you watch yourself on, being too cynical and, like, being blocked off from people just because of, like, the old situations that were, like, jerks to you. I hope this reading was of resonance in some type of way for you, Capricorn. If it was, be sure to let me know in the comments below. Be sure to give this video a like and subscribe as well, Capricorn. Also, I do readings for all the zodiac signs, not just you. Oh, I called you guys Capricorn, Virgo. I'm so sorry. It's like 3 o'clock in the morning for me. Y'all are the last reading, Virgo. Don't hold it against me. I still love you. Please give me a... Oh gosh, it's already karma happening. Please love me still, Virgo. I love you so much. If you can forgive me for that, be sure to share my videos with a friend that's into tarot. And I'm going to just close out this reading because I'm a train wreck for you guys. I love you guys so much, Virgo. And I'll connect with you guys sometime in the future. Hopefully, anyways. Bye, Virgo.